Hi, welcome back to Molecular Docking, AutoDock Part 3. So in the previous videos, we covered the ligand preparation, protein preparation in the Part 1, the Part 2, the prepared ligand and protein in PDB converted into PDBQT files, and then we created the grid parameter file and docking parameter file. And these docking parameter files converted into log files by using the command prompt. So now in this video, we can cover the remaining part, that is analyzing of the results and then viewing of the interactions between the protein and ligand by using the Drug Discovery Studio. So we can go to this AutoDock tools. So go to the analyze. So after completion of command prompt given in the previous video, so this completed job, AutoDock 4, we converted the parameter file, docking parameter file, into docking log file. So this log file is created in the folder. So you can see that in this folder what we created, so the DLG file, ADLG log file, and also GLG file, that is a grid log file created. Both are created along with the some receptor map files also created in the folder. So now we can go to this AutoDock tools, analyze, docking, open. So here we need to select that DLG file, that is a docking log file. It will give the one message that is indicating that read 10 docked confirmations. So in the docking kept that 10 runs should undergo for each molecule, so that's why it is given 10 result. So then in the same analyze, go to the macromolecule, open. So automatically it will open the receptor, and then go to the same analyze, grids, open. The grids files what generated in the folder, these are going to open. Okay, and close this one, and again go to the analyze, go to clusters, show. So it will show the clusters of your compound. Just close that. Then go to the analyze again, confirmations, play ranked by energy. So by this it will give this window, this short window. So here we can see this open panels to change play options, this unlike symbol. So if we click this one, so the set play options, that is show info, and I am clicking the build hydrogen bonds also. So these two I am making clicking. So it will show the hydrogen bonds, what, where it is forming. So that triclosan it is making an interaction with the isoleucine 194 and giving the information of that ligand having the binding energy or docking score -6.92, and ligand efficiency giving, and inhibitory constant, that is Ki, it is 8.45 micromolar. With this concentration, inhibitory constant is inhibitory action is present in this protein. So we can, this is a confirmation one. So totally it given the 10 confirmations. So we can check one by one by clicking this arrow mark. So just I am removing this one. So we can see here 6.87, the second confirmation with the linkage isoleucine 194. And next confirmation, it is not making any interactions. It is -6.86, 6.57, does not make interactions, hydrogen bond, 6.54, confirmation 5, confirmation 6, 6.49, confirmation 6, confirmation 7, 6.38, no interactions, 6.37, confirmation 8, confirmation 9, 6.36, and last one, confirmation 6.31. So among this, if you observe that confirmation 1 -6.92 and confirmation 2 -6.87 along with the hydrogen bond formation we can observe. So to download this complex, that is along the ligand and protein complex, so now the confirmation 1 is there. So see the option here, 1 it is there. So we can make a right complex. So we can save in a PDBQT format. I am mentioning as a complex one, that is confirmation one, PDBQT save. And similarly, going to the second confirmation. that is -6.87 with the inhibitory constant of 9.18 micromolar. So same right complex. So I am making it as a complex 2. That is confirmation 2 of the result. PDB QT. Save. So remaining conformations are not making any hydrogen bond interactions. Only the conformation 1 and 2 are making. So that 2 only I am saved it as a complex with the along with the ligand and protein. So these are the 10 results we are getting. Docking result and inhibitory constant. So and we can visualize interactions in this autodock, but we cannot see clearly in this autodock. So we can choose the Discovery Studio for good visualization. So you can see here isoleucine 194, it is making a hydrogen bonding interaction. Green color it is representing. So in this form we can view the result in the autodock. So for the best view, so we can see in the Discovery Studio. So we can easily find the good interactions. So how many interactions are formed, we can in that Discovery Studio. So in that folder, what I created, complex 1 and complex 2, conformation 1 and conformation 2. So just I am clicking this complex 1. So it is going to open in the Discovery Studio as I install in my system. So it will open the BioVia Discovery Studio. It is a solution for computational chemistry and biology. The version is 2019. So all the plugins it is checking and it is going to opening. So this window we can see that Discovery Studio visualizer. So already we click that complex 1. So it is loading. So you can see here the protein along with the ligand, it is there. So the ligand. So go to this non-bond interactions and click this ligand interactions. So you can see the different interactions between the protein and the ligand. So we can easily see the 2D picture clearly. What are the interactions are there by clicking this show 2D diagram. So you can see here. So I'm increasing the size for visualization. So this is a triclosan drug. It is binding with the one hydrogen bond interaction it is making with the isoleucine 194. So this green color is indicating the conventional hydrogen bond. And white color is indicating the carbon hydrogen bond. And this pink color is indicating the pi-pi stacking with the phenylalanine. Pi-pi stacking. And light pink color it is representing the alkyl and pi-alkyl bonds it is making with the ligand is making the with the interactions making with the protein. So we can see that complex 2 also you can visualize complex 2. So I'm just closing the complex 1. So now it is showing this complex 2 2D diagram. So same isoleucine 194, it is showing hydrogen bond making with the OH group of triclosan. So which group it is making, that also we can clearly observe. So OH part of the triclosan it is making an interaction, and this is the pi-pi stacking with the phenylalanine as like in the conformation 1. So likewise we can visualize the result and we can save this image and we can use in our work. So this is a complete about the autodock, from the ligand preparation, protein preparation, PDBQT file formation, grid parameter file formation, docking parameter file generation and conversion of this parameter files into log files, and analyzing of the results in the AutoDoc, and finally viewing of the results in the Discovery Studio Visualizer. So thank you for watching. Please see the all these three parts, part 1, part 2 and part 3, to completely get the information regarding this AutoDoc molecular docking. Thank you.